from?
My name is Vince. I'm from Orlando.
Orlando, Florida. Now, how did you find out about the Ichiku thing here?
My buddy Jim over there.
Is that right?
Yeah, I don't know how he found out about it.
How'd you find out about it?
I found out about it from the internet.
The internet. That's a good method of getting a hold of everything here, the internet. Hey, y'all got your own natural air conditioning up here in the breeze. You got a nice shot of the stage up here. Debbie, can you get a shot of the stage? Of course, they're in between some sets right now, but everything's looking great, isn't it?
It's looking great. Yeah, once Ken came, he provided the generator. Our generator didn't work. Tennessee people are nice.
When did you get into the area?
This morning.
See, Vince kind of slept most of the time, so we did all the driving. So they know that we had to drive all night long to get here. And then they wouldn't let us in because we got here too early. And then we had trouble with their generator. But we met some locals here that were really good, and they helped us out. And we got our generator going, our air conditioner's going, and we're like living large now.
Now, what kind of bus you have here, and how long have you had this thing fixed up?
Well, this is Ken's bus. He's one of the locals that's up here. That's Ken over there.
Oh, okay. Anyway, y'all drove up here and met him and then came out here with his bus, right?
Yeah. Well, actually, a friend of his runs an auto shop where we were trying to get parts to fix our generator. And then he introduced us to Ken because he had a generator. So then everything worked out for the best. And we were down and out, and now we're up and happy, and we're going to enjoy all the shows.
I'll tell you what, you got the best seat in the house. Turning around here, you got a great shot of the twin video screens. You can see pretty much, and I guess you got binoculars too.
Yes, we do.
And you can darn hear the music fine here, right?
Yes, we can. But we want to say special thanks to Will and Ken. They really helped us out down here, and the locals are great. Yeah.
All right, all the way from Orlando, Florida. Now, the guy that owns the thing, come on out here and have a seat. Let's talk to you and see where you're from. And
how you doing?
Pretty good. Your name, where are you from?
Ken Jones. I live next door to this Ichiku Park.
Is that right here on Bushy Branch Road?
Yes, sir.
All right, and when did you first find out they was coming here?
3 or 4 months ago. And what's funny is I hunted all this land, and now I'm out here partying with rock and roll. My grandpa wouldn't believe this if he's still living.
Never would have believed that all these famous people would come here.
No, I can't believe it myself, because I listened to all these guys back in the 70s when I was growing up. Here they are in my home neighborhood.
Do you have any favorites that are here today or this weekend?
My favorite's probably the Marshall Tucker Band. Uh-huh. They was always my favorite. And tonight I think we got Sammy Hagar, which is one of my favorite too. But all of them, I like them all because I like older rock and roll better because I'm an older person.
I'll tell you what, a great facility out here. I can't believe how well kept the lawn is. It looks like a huge residential lawn, the way they've got it manicured, this field manicured up.
It's hard to believe what all they've done out here in what slow time, because if you'd have seen this 3 months ago, you never thought nothing like this was going to happen.
I'll tell you what, we are real excited. Everybody helping us was real excited on getting over here. You'd think we was going to Disney World.
Hey, I hope it turns out good, and I hope Manchester has this every year for a few years. I really do, because I think if you ain't been here and looked around, there's a lot to do with kids and everything else. It's really nice.
All right, well, we're going to be looking, just talking to a lot of the vendors and a lot of other people. Now, how did you come about fixing up this old bus?
I go to Winston Cup races, and I told my dad, he always had an RV like, and I kept seeing school buses. And I told him, I said, I'll buy one and we'll build it up. So we build it up, and we go to Winston Cup races, and we also go camping in it a lot. So I brought it down here for all 5 days.
I like this deck you built on top of it. You got a nice awning. And it's just like it's just worth $1 million as far as what you've got down here today.
Oh, I wouldn't take nothing for it. I built every bit of it. And like I said, we can see the races when we go to it. And now we can see the stage backstage. We don't even have to walk up there. We sat up here last night while they played music and listened to them.
Checking it out.
Yeah, it was nice.
Debbie, if you can get a shot, the Opryland tram is making its way around the grounds. Of course, this tram is supplied from the folks at Opryland. And they're going to be operating throughout the weekend out here, taking people to and from the different sites. And just a sprawling area, there's still, this is of course early Thursday evening, and there's still a lot of people trickling in.
Oh yeah, they've been coming in. Like I said, I live next door and I run in and out, and I've been watching cars come in for the last 3 days, and they're still coming in as we speak right now.
All right, and a local what, and your name again?
Ken Jones.
Ken Jones right here, lives out here on Bushy Branch Road. Got this great vehicle they used to go to the NASCAR races in. Set up out here, got a nice view of the stage area.
You know, we're going to get warmed up. We got some more groups coming up. I think we got the leftover from the Jimi Hendrix band coming up here, right?
Yeah, I believe you're right. Rick Springfield just got through, and I believe you're right. I believe the leftovers from Hendrix is coming up next.
All right. Hey, stay with us on the Tennessee Valley Cable Network, bringing it all home to you from the 99 Itchicoo Park concert, located right here in Manchester, Tennessee, right off of I-24. Hey, what about this gal over here? You want to be on TV? Talk to us.
They're from
all
Florida.
Right. All right, they're from Florida. Y'all come on down here and talk to us there for a minute. Come on down here. These gals from Florida, come on down here. Don't y'all want to talk? Come on down here. Already all the way from Orlando, Florida, barefoot and having a good time. It's better than being down there on the beach in Florida, isn't it?
Well, yeah, it is now, certainly.
Uh-huh.
We're having fun.
Y'all ever have anything this big down there?
Sure.
What's your name now?
Elizabeth.
Elizabeth, you're?
Holly.
Both of you from Orlando,
yeah.
Right? Okay, well, welcome up here to Tennessee. Have you ever been to this part of Tennessee before?
Yeah.
You like the climate here? You like the hills, the mountains?
Yeah, the hills are nice.
It's beautiful coming
very
in.
Nice.
Uh-huh. It was really nice.
All right. Hey, you'll have something to tell them when you go back home, right?
Certainly. Right. Hey, man, the people here are fantastic. That's all I know. I've never been disappointed in Tennessee. People are great.
I said the people are very nice here.
All right, hey. Stay with us right here on Tennessee Valley Cable Network. More from Itchicoo Park 99.
Marcus.
1, 2. You got me? 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2. And hey, we're rolling, aren't we? Hey, we're rolling right here. TVCN.
It's
we're
a back. Media circus! Media circus! Thing.
Hey, we're having a great time out here at Itchicoo 99.
Hey, Dave. Yes, right. We are.
Now, what does it take to get you out of that shirt there? It looks like you got a Coors Light.
Well, you want
beer,
it?
Beer, wolf. Look at, no, take it out.
Okay, all right.
I'll well, get you one, know. We get one from this distributor later.
Oh, okay.
I like your shirt there.
So do I. I've had this a while. I used to be a Coors Light Comedy Commando. It's true. Anyway, how you doing?
Hey, pretty good. We just got here. Just came right in off of the interstate, and I've been talking to some of the people out here all the way. We just got through talking to a bunch. Drove up here from Orlando, Florida.
Wow. Well, I got here from Atlanta.
Is that right?
Yeah, they hired me out of Atlanta to come. So
how many clowns we got out here? I guess everybody's a clown after about 10 o'clock. At
after
night,
about or, yeah, yeah, you're right. By Friday midnight, the joint will be jumping with clowns. But there are two or three of us who are professionals. Everybody else is just an amateur. So
you probably were down there clowning around during the Olympics, right?
As a matter of fact, yeah, I did. I got to work at the, I'm a part of what I do is also pantomime, so it was great to be there to perform for the people in the Olympic Village, because you got all those languages and you don't have to speak English, you can just do mime.
And of course, we're here Thursday night. This is the kickoff night for Itchicoo Park. A lot of people, the vendors are getting set up, people are streaming in. It's just kind of a preliminary, kind of the warm-up time.
Exactly, it's the warm-up time. I think tomorrow will be good and Saturday will be fantastic.
Yeah.
So if you haven't been, if this is over by the time you guys see this on Tennessee Valley Cable, you've already blown your opportunity to be here. And if it happens to air before that, come on down.
Well, we're hoping that it'll be here next year, could show this to get everybody excited about next year's show.
Good idea. I hope I'm here next year, too. This is a great concept. I hope it works. I really do.
I know Mother Nature's helped us. It's clouded up. We had a nice breeze. It threatened a little rain, but I could use a little sprinkle myself.
Hey. Well, the bathrooms are over there. They're little gray buildings. You need to do a little sprinkle. Oh, this is cable. Can I say that?
Yeah,
okay.
That's right.
Okay. Yeah, this has been amazing. Last night was great camping out here. It was nice and cool. It was just delightful. And no bugs. I don't know where they keep the bugs here, but, man, I haven't been bit once. And I kind of didn't expect that. So
I think they must have all hovered around these beer tents. That's where they're.
Oh, man, those are the barflies.
Intoxicated, and they.
They're barflies, of course. I should have thought so.
But you've got a lot of people out here. A lot of vendors, arts and crafts vendors. Debbie, if you can pan on around, they're lined up on both sides of the road here. Look at here.
Stuff. Look at that. More stuff. Really? I got bandanas. You got barbecue. You got Cajun food. You got margaritas. You got beer. You got ribs. You got, what do you like? It's all here. Believe me, it's all here.
And of course, right over there, the bridge of size, and then right through there is the arena, and they got those two big, nice, high definition LED screens.
Oh, yeah, they're great. Nice. Yeah, it's beautiful. Boy. Last night they were testing them out, and it looked really, really cool. Really, really gorgeous. I just hope that there's lots and lots of people here to appreciate how hard these folks have worked already. Yeah. And this is just being the first year. That's the best part, is that they've really, you know, they've done a bang up job for the first year out, and it's just going to get better from here on down.
All right. Hey, good luck to you, and we hope to see some more of you here during the week.
Oh, yeah.
Hey, I'm telling you what, it don't get any better than right here at 99 Ichiku.
Ichiku. It's all too beautiful. See you later.
See you later. Stay with us right here on TVCN. We'll be back with more good times from Ichiku Park 99. It's finest, helping out with security tonight, Tennessee Highway Patrol, right here, helping us out, maintaining law and order. We're going to be talking to more people, some of these arts and crafts vendors and people, and I want to talk to this gal up here. She's even reading fortunes. She might be better than Ethel is on that fortune reading. Stand by right here on TVCN. There comes the Mayfield bunch. Already out of ice cream, going to get more. Hey, we'll be back with more. We're going to take us a little break and go to the local watering hole. Hey, we're on the air. We're back down here at Ichiku 99 TVCN. We got the cigar man here, right? Are you the only cigar guy here today?
That's right. We got them all.
Where y'all from?
Fayetteville, Arkansas.
Fayetteville, Arkansas. You got some of Castro's finest here, right?
That's correct.
All right. I don't have any knowledge about cigars. Now, what's the difference? What do you got here? Give us a little education on what you're selling.
Looks like I don't really know here. Just a bunch of good cigars from Nicaragua and.
Nicaragua. So. Is this Nicaragua cigars? You get a shot of that?
Yeah, I think so.
They come all the way from Nicaragua.
Sure enough.
And I guess that's tobacco down there is pretty good. Nicaraguan cigar. Hey, my business hadn't prospered that well yet, so I'm not going to smoke one. And then you got some others over here. Where are these from?
I believe those are the South American there.
South American?
Yeah.
Then you got some others here.
Yeah,
now, these are from the Philippines right here. I don't even know how to pronounce that. You got them from the Philippines.
Man, there's the cigar connoisseur.
The cigar connoisseur, come on over here.
Lay the hammer on him,
right? We're from the Tennessee Valley Cable Network. Where are y'all from?
We're from Bentonville, Arkansas.
Bentonville, Arkansas. Get a shot of that shirt there. Get that out of the way. Look at that, Debbie. Get a shot of his shirt. Turn on around there. No. Well, okay.
There you
That's
go.
All right.
I don't know what that one is.
Bull of the Woods or whatever it is. Is that what you... Anyway, you got a lot of esoteric cigars for sale out here at Ichiku, right?
That's right. I've got a lot of hand-rolled cigars, tobacco products, cigarettes, tobacco accessories.
Yeah. For people that feel like they're on top of the world and come out here and watch their favorite rock group and smoke one of them great cigars.
Exactly.
Hey. Where do you go after this? Are you going to another big concert after Ichiku?
No, Bradley probably will. He's getting ready to head out and hit the circuit this summer and hit several more.
Y'all go to county fairs and state fairs, things like
That's
that?
That's where we found Bradley was at a county fair.
Is that right?
Yep.
Yeah. We've got some wild ones here in Middle Tennessee.
Oh, I'll tell you now. He's a wild one.
All right, all the way from, where was that in Arkansas?
Bentonville, Arkansas.
Bentonville. Hey, I know where Bentonville, that's where they started Walmart.
That's right, y'all get over that way, y'all come see us.
Hey,
now.
We sure will. Hey,
okay.
Thanks for talking
Thank
with
you.
Us. Stay with us, you never know what you're going to see next out here at Ichiku 99 on TVCN. Hey, we're rolling. We got another great vendor down here at the Ichiku 99 cable viewers. Your name, where are you from?
It's Lena Dudas, and I'm from Tiger, Georgia.
Tiger, Georgia. Step aside here. I want to get a picture of this Blair Witch right here. Big media queen. Just in time for the Halloween season. Y'all got all kinds of great things here for the seasons coming up. For Halloween, Thanksgiving, Christmas, gifts. You got it all right here.
That's right.
Now, I'll tell you, you have a selection. You got Native American stuff. You got wind chimes. You got all kinds of incense burners. And it just goes on and on.
We try to have a variety of everything.
A souvenir for Ichiku 99. These people that, you know, really want to get into the culture, that you can help them, right?
I can do my best. I'll answer any questions I can.
Where are y'all from?
I'm from Tiger, Georgia.
Tiger, Georgia.
And you, Clayton.
And have you got other festivals that you're going to this season?
Yeah, I'll be in Hiawassee Fair in October and Tocoa Harvest Festival in November. And from there, I'm not sure at this point.
Just a great lineup of things, all kinds of craft items. Now, do y'all make any of these things yourself? Or
do everything ourselves.
You do
everything's
it
handmade.
Everything's
yes.
handmade. And it is you got some great selections, all kinds of unique items. Debbie, are you getting a good shot of a representation of this stuff? Hey, we hope to maybe come back here and spend some more time and look it over.
Sounds good.
Thank you very much.
Thank
Thanks
you.
For coming to Ichiku 99.
Thank you.
All right, stay with us. We're going to talk to more people. We got a Harley Davidson place down here we're going to visit, the motorcycle bunch. So, hey, you never know what you're going to see down here at Ichiku 99. So stay with us. Hey, cable viewers, we're out here. Of course, another great vendor. We got fresh Gulf shrimp. This is Cajun Cuisine. And this is, I'll let them pronounce that name up there, a little French name. And we got the Master Chef right around the corner here. If you come around here and stick your camera in here, and let's see if he'll talk to us here a minute. This guy right here knows what it's all about. He's playing that Credence.
Credence
right, playing that Credence there. Getting ready to swing here in the Ichiku 99. And y'all are all the way from Louisiana, maybe?
Raceland, Louisiana. We got 3,000 pounds of 1620s, alligator sauce pecan, okra shrimp, crab, oyster, seafood gumbo, smoked sausage, jambalaya, ribs, hot wings. If you want to eat, it's a place to come.
It sounds like good. Are they giving some samples out there?
Yeah, sure.
But we might give us a little sample. And for the cable viewers that are watching, we go into a lot of different markets. Are you going to be at some other festivals coming up in the Mid-South area?
Well, we're going to be at the races. NASCAR races. And we do a lot of private caterings, too, and so forth.
All right. Now, where you're from in Louisiana, is that near Lafayette, New Orleans?
No, that's south of New Orleans, 45 miles on the Bayou Lafourche.
All right. Hey, a little geography lesson here at Ichiku 99. Hey, I hope y'all sell all you got here.
We plan to.
All right. Well, you helicoptering in if you run out?
I don't know. I got all the guff shrimp I could get. 3,000 pounds of 1620s and everything else.
All right. Y'all come on down here to Ichiku and have some of this great Cajun stuff. They've got it. They got it from all over the United States down here, all over the world, as a matter of fact, at Ichiku 99. Thanks for talking with us.
Thank you.
Thank you. Stay with us. First, we're back. We're rolling. We got some people here all the way from Kentucky. Is that right?
Eastern Kentucky.
Eastern Kentucky. Did y'all come down here on the two-wheelers?
Yeah, we rode motorcycles
is
down.
That right? Hey, Debbie, swing on around here. Look at a shot of that one right there. Look at that nice-looking machine. He's ready to be born to be wild, right? Steppin' Wolf coming up later on this weekend.
That's it. John Kay's going to be here. It's going to be great. It's a party and a half.
Have you ever been to anything like this before?
Yeah, a few things. This is a good one. Hopefully it'll be a good start for a second. Maybe get better.
Now, let me ask you this. How did you hear about Ichiku 99?
A friend of ours from Ohio found it on the internet.
And
the word spread. And
I hear more and more people say they heard about it on the internet.
That's pretty much how we found out about it. And I've seen a lot of other people at other rallies that we've been to in the summer, you know, and there's been a lot of people that I haven't known that have heard of this. And that they found out it pretty much the same way. You know, it seems to spread the word.
So you got must have a lot of favorites here to bring you all the way down here to Manchester, Tennessee.
Yeah, it just looked like a good time, you know, good people, you know.
Certainly a great place. Hey,
type atmosphere where you can have a good time.
That's right. Hey, and I want to invite y'all out. Come back next time and come on back down here to Middle Tennessee if y'all get a chance. Go on down there and visit Jack Daniel Distillery over in Lynchburg.
All right.
Just next county over.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Let's go fight this rain and hail.
All right. Hey, stay with us. More people coming in here from all over the place. Where are y'all from? Same place, so Kentucky. Can we get a shot of you? Get a shot up there. They rode in here too on their motorcycles. Two-wheelers. Ichiku 99. The fans, they love the music, and they're here to celebrate the renewal of this great music that we all grew up with. Stay with us here on TVCN. We're going to be talking to more people from all over the United States out here at Ichiku 99. Band's cranking up again. I don't know who it is, but it's sounding mighty fine. We got some people here with some unique architecture. I don't know where they're from, but I'll tell you what, we like this bus you got here.
How you doing?
Pretty good, pretty good.
Peace and love from Ichiku 99.
Yeah.
Rock on.
Where y'all at up?
I'm from Raleigh, North Carolina. My friend here, this is his rig.
Hey, right. this is a great looking rig. Debbie, you might want to cross the road so you don't get blocked again. Your name, where you from?
I'm Mike from Nashville.
From Nashville?
Yep.
Now, how long have you had this truck?
Since 79.
79. And does it give you much wind drag going down the interstate?
Nah, not too bad. We put helium in the tires.
Helium's in the tires.
Right,
yeah, that's
right.
That's the way to go. And you're here to rock and roll and enjoy this great music.
Absolutely, we're gonna have a great time. Have a look inside.
Have a look inside, we will. Now, what other events do you go to? Evidently, you're a well-seasoned traveler to have such an outfit like this.
I usually go to caving events. We're in the National Speleological Society.
Oh, really?
So this is a little bit different. A lot of fun, though.
It is a lot of fun. And you got some other great people here. Of course, y'all, where are y'all from?
Raleigh.
Raleigh, North Carolina.
Raleigh, North Carolina.
North Carolina.
Johnson City, Tennessee.
Johnson, up there in Johnson City, East Tennessee. But just a great place. Y'all can just get up in there and have a big party.
This is the blue bus, and the blue bus is calling us.
The blue bus is calling us.
That's right.
The blue bus. Just another unique type of architecture here visiting for Ichiku 99. We're going to show you a lot more. So stay with us. The party's just starting. This is just Thursday night, Thursday afternoon.
We multiply.
It's just a little after 5 o'clock on Thursday. This thing's just getting winding up. And hey, I'm glad I bought a couple of cases of tape before we came over. We got plenty of tape. We're going to be shooting here all weekend, giving you the time of your life from Ichiku 99. Stay with us right here on Tennessee Valley Cable Network. We'll be back with more. It looks like a Lazy Boy furniture sale in here.
Right. It's a 63 bus. It's got a six-cylinder in it.
Come on behind us. Look at this. I mean, everybody travels first class, right?
Well, what you're seeing here is you're seeing the man's sleeping deck is right around behind you up here over top.
Uh-huh.
And the original bus, this isn't the all-original bus. The original bus had a 69 Volkswagen on top of it.
Uh-huh.
But it rusted off. So he got it and took that down, and he's a carpenter.
Yeah.
And a pretty good one from what you see right here. And he manufactured this.
Debbie, you're going to have to get over here. Let us move over where she is. Debbie, get a shot up there in the loft. And this is really something. Last time I saw something like this was out near, when I was living out near San Francisco, and they had all this going on.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, you see a lot of weird stuff in San Francisco. Some people go out there and see it, and then they bring it home with them. That's what happened here.
Oh man, isn't this something? Great, you got these. You got lamps here. You got table play games. A little bit of everything.
Yeah, all of this works off of his 12 volt battery, so you don't have much of a problem. He's got two of them, so it services him quite well.
Hey, this is great. This is just the tip of the iceberg, cable viewers. I hope we get to see a lot more of this out here. People traveling all over the place.
The guy's a spelunker, and he goes down in holes and grounds and down into caverns and canyons and all this stuff, and he brings back these little trinkets like this. This is where you find them at, down in the ground.
Oh, man.
And he finds those things right there. Those are actually stones that are split in two along the windshield.
Look at those little discs along the windshield. Those are stones that have been split in two.
So he's quite a unique individual, but that's what it takes. That's what makes the world go round.
And you got all this area up here to sleep around.
Right. This is all sleep around area.
Uh-huh.
But he's a good fellow. He's a real, real good fellow. He's an easy spirit, and he's a free spirit, so he's real lovable.
All right. I'm looking around here. I keep looking for, what was the guy in Born to Be Wild, Peter?
The guy that played Peter Fonda.
I keep looking around for Peter Fonda.
Well, actually, Jack Nicholson's up here.
He is.
Yeah, he's here with us.
All right.
But y'all have fun. This is what it's about. Y'all having fun too now. It's not only just for us. You people that are doing this media coverage are doing real good.
All right. We're going to try to stay sober the rest of the night and drug free. So y'all stay with us right here on TVC.
Drug free is the way to be.
That's right. Stay with us. A lot of these guys used to do all that years ago, but now we just kind of sit back and have a cold one, right?
That's it. Look, hey, that's the drug of choice in the 90s right there and all through 2000.
All right.
There you go.
Hey, stay with us right here on TVC and Tennessee Valley Cable Network. We're going to be back with more. We're going to have a good time. We're here to stay. Bye. Hey, we're rolling again. We're out here at the Ichiku Park 99, cable viewers. And, you know, we got a lot of media here from all over the United States. And I just happened to talk to these guys a while ago. We're backstage. Mark Farner with Grand Funk Railroad just finished up a great set, didn't he?
Yeah, he did a real good job for all the hits that they had throughout the years. It's good to see him not disappointing up there, and they can still wail after all these years.
It makes me feel good because I'll be 51 next month. But y'all are out of Philadelphia, right?
Flew in yesterday and flying back Monday after the long 4-day event here, and looking forward to seeing plenty of great entertainment.
What media group are you representing?
I represent M Entertainment, a production company out of Philadelphia, and we're here covering the event, and we'll be sending back stills and another matter. And we've already been very pleased and maybe a little even pleasantly surprised on the bands that have been here. The Outfield did a great show earlier today, and Dave Mason opened the day and did an excellent job. Rick Springfield, you might giggle a little bit seeing Rick Springfield, a thing like that, but he put on one hell of a show, and
he had some big hits,
and he's turning 50 too. So
is that right? Well, he's comfortable with all these people.
Yeah, he doesn't feel so bad now. So you have somebody that you can talk about the old days with there, right?
All right, he's this many.
And are you from Philadelphia also?
Yes, sir. WTTM Radio out of Philadelphia.
WTTM. Now, can we get you on the internet? Y'all on the internet yet?
I think the capability is there. It's a combination of four different stations out of Philly. It's Nassau Broadcasting. You can definitely get them on the internet.
Now, what's your format up there?
Well, we do actually four different formats. We have a Top 40. We have an all-sports radio. We have a middle of the road. And we also have an all-religion station. So right now, this is going on the Top 40.
All right. Sounds good. What do you think about this resurgence in the music? Of course, a lot of the agencies advertising agencies are using this music to sell all kinds of commodities on network TV and so forth.
Definitely. It's crazy what's going on these days. This definitely has making of it a big hit right here. You've seen what happened to the good side and the bad side of Woodstock. It has that potential. I don't know if a town like this is really prepared for something like that, but you look around how huge it is here, and so far it seems everyone's having fun. No one's out of hand, although, of course, the bands like this kind of cater to a different style environment there, and that's the big thing. Everyone's having a good time. So far, the rain showed up. Crowds are a little late getting here, but it is Thursday, and kids are back in school, so hopefully the weekend is going to be going crazy here.
And we got a little drizzle right now, but we haven't had any much rain here. Everybody's crying drought. The farmers, I'm sure they'd like a little bit of drizzle.
No doubt about it. I mean, you can just look around how things are turning brown and things like that. And actually, after today, it was hot today. I got a little barbecued myself, and I think it feels good after a long day. People cooling down in the rain. Looking for a good night of music tonight. Apparently, Sammy Hagar is going to wrap it up tonight. Should be a rocking night.
Now, are y'all going to be in here for the whole show, the whole weekend?
Yes, sir. We're here all 4 days, and hopefully we can survive and not get too crispy, not get too burnt up.
Are you staying at some of the great Southern hospitality here in the Manchester area?
Actually, we lucked out. We have friends and relatives that live like a block away, so free housing right down the road, and the beer store's right across the street, so it works out well for everyone.
I'll tell you what, y'all just keep getting better and better, don't
you? Oh, it's great. Yeah, I mean, that's all we need. I mean, we're working, but we're having fun at the same time. So you take advantage of it. And outside of an occasional drizzle, as you know, drizzle and glasses don't mix. So I'll be wiping these out, quite a bit. But I'm looking forward to spending the next few days here. And like John said, I just hope we can survive, and maybe a little 54 sunscreen, and we'll be all right.
Now, I noticed on the network television this morning they had Dick Clark on there, I guess, celebrating 40 years of music, and he all started this thing back in the late 50s, I guess, in Philadelphia. Right?
In Philadelphia, man, American Bandstand, and the Philadelphia has a great tradition of music, starting with your Chubby Checkers and your Frankie Avalons and all that, but all the way up to your Hall & Oates now, and mm-hmm. Boyz II Men out in Will Smith.
Yeah.
Outside of, is from Philly, and so Philadelphia has a great tradition of music, and just glad we can take some of the highlights of Itchy Coo in Tennessee back to Philly and let them know what it's like here.
All right. Hey, it's certainly nice talking to these media types. We all get along well. And the rain is starting to come down a little bit more. I like it. It's a nice little shower out.
Cooling things down. It feels good. Getting ready for some more rock and roll. And looks like a great night ahead.
Welcome to Tennessee. Y'all need to get over here and visit the Jack Daniel's Distillery. and come on back down here for the Jack Daniel barbecue,
yes,
right?
That's a must can do. Free Jack is a good plan. Let's go with that.
They always throw a big party on Saturday night after that show too.
Really? Well, let's see.
Y'all need to talk your bosses into coming back down.
We stay here, or do we go to Jack Daniel?
we might want to.
Oh, okay. October. When is it October? Because I'll be back in here in October.
Yeah.
So we'll have to check that out. But yeah, that's a beautiful thing about Tennessee and the South. You have your Jack Daniels distillery. You have Nashville, which is the music capital of the world. And
we got it all right here.
This is a place to be. And I give the people in Nashville and the companies in Nashville, credit for getting this thing together. They did an excellent job, and I didn't know what to expect, when we got here, and we're pleasantly surprised. They did an excellent, excellent job.
All right, Brad Baker, hats off to you. You did a good job out here. Y'all need to get back. We need to get out of the rain. We're going to have another refreshing beverage. Andy says he's going to take time out here in a minute. Stay with us right here on Tennessee Valley Cable Network. You never know what you're going to see next. We're going to talk to more people, more campers, and the press, everybody here. Stay with us and support our sponsors on this show. Thanks. Yeah, right here, the peace sign. There you go, the old peace sign. Thanks.
For it, lower the tripod.
Hey, cable viewers, we're back here at HQ Park 99, and we're on top of a great observation bus here overlooking the stage area. And if Andy, turn out that light, that stage light you got right there, turn that out. Now let's carefully zoom over here to the stage area if you can, just kind of hold it. Here, I'll take that light off your hands. We got a generator going in the background, keeping the buses powered up, and these people have got to keep their refrigerators going because they got a lot of cold stuff they got to take care of out here. We're out here at Ichiku Park 99, and as you can see, the remnants, I guess, of Jimi Hendrix Band is getting ready to play here shortly. And they got those great new LED screens that they're debuting, high definition television, bigger than the Jumbotron on Times Square, according to the video producer. But of course, they're getting ready to put on a big show. A lot of people are still coming into the area. This is the Thursday night show. And of course, after the, I guess this is the Jimi Hendrix Band, the remnants of Jimi Hendrix Band. They're gonna have Sammy Hagar next. That's gonna close it out for a Thursday night. We still got a lot of food vendors to go see, right?
No doubt, man. It's a great time out here at Ichiku Park.
I'll tell you what, we made a lot of friends with the media, a lot of media here from all over the United States. We had a great time. And I'll tell you what, these people are giving us a great time here. Appreciate you letting us shoot this portion of our show from atop your bus there.
Yeah, that's all right, man. That's what it's all about, man, helping people to get a view of what's going on. That's why we're all out here having a good time.
Good job, man.
Hey, there he is. Get back here. Beat back here just a little bit. Here he is. Can you get a shot of that, Andy? Andy's got the light on it. Yeah, you got to have that light on to get a shot.
Hey, everybody.
But this guy
come
here.
Come here and have a good time, man. It's a great time down here. The bands are awesome, man. These guys practice hard to sound like they originally did. So they're really putting on a show.
I tell you what, y'all need to be down here because we've never been to anything like this.
Getting more and more people are coming in thousands all day long. People are coming in and having a good time. And everybody's helping everybody out, People that don't have everything they need, people are helping them, and things are good, man.
It doesn't get any better than this. That's what I always say. And I'll tell you what, y'all have got the hospitality. You got this nice area right here. I mean, it's nice.
Absolutely. And you're welcome. More than welcome to it. And come back and take some more videos here, and we'll see what's going on down the street later on.
Yeah. All right. Okay, Andy, kick that light out. Swing on back to the stage. They got something going on down there. I can't really make out what it is. But
another band's playing, getting ready to play.
Now we're
gonna go check it out.
Part of our staff has gone, had to make a run into Manchester. We're expecting them back soon.
Okay.
So y'all gonna walk up there and watch them live?
Yep. But you go ahead and feel free,
We appreciate it. Thanks a lot.
All right,
just some of the behind the scenes stuff going on. You still rolling there, Andy?
No doubt, man. We're rolling. We're trying to catch as much as we can out here.
Ichiku Park 99. Of course, we're up here. This is about as close as we can get tonight.
Exactly. They wouldn't let us in earlier today, but they said that the rules will probably change by tomorrow and we'll be able to get some interviews from backstage.
Yeah. I'll tell you what, those LED video screens, they look pretty nice. Let me look through that viewfinder and see what you got here. Oh yeah, that's nice. That's coming through real good. Like that. That is nice. Anyway, right out here at Ichiku Park, you got three big screen TVs. On over here, there's the other one. And of course, the band playing right now, I believe, is left over from the Jimi Hendrix era. But look at this shot that we have. We appreciate these people letting us use the top of their bus. They got a nice sun deck up here. And as you can see, three video screens. There's one in the middle of the stage, and then there's one on the left and one on the right. They've really gone all out here, and this has been just the opening night here at Ichiku Park. Yeah, we're here in Manchester, Tennessee. We're having a great time. Want y'all to come out to Ichiku Park 99. You see us? We're trying to put up a tent here. We got Andy helping, representative with the, is it Mark Entwistle Band?
John Entwistle Band.
John Entwistle Band tomorrow. And of course, you're from England, right?
Yeah.
You're trying to get your tent up. Now, why are you having to pitch a tent here tonight here?
Because we enjoy camping, you know, and so.
All right.
We're out in the country, so we thought we'd, you know, do some camping. What most people do, you know, in the summertime in the countryside.
I'll tell you what, y'all just enjoyed a great eclipse over there.
A few days ago, yeah. I didn't actually see it, I was here, so.
and you come in here, what do you think about the Ichiku Park phenomenon?
I don't really know, because I just got here, so, I mean, you know, I don't really know. I mean, it looks pretty good, the stage looks really good. And the sound seems pretty good, but that's all we know so far.
Now, what's your connection with John? Remnant of the Who band,
technician.
Right?
Oh, yeah, of course. Well, it's only John Entwistle, it's his own band, but...
What part did he play in the Who when he was popular?
Who, John Entwistle?
What did he play?
He played guitar.
Played guitar for the
Yeah,
Who.
He did.
He did a good job, and anyway, he's going to be here this weekend.
He'll be here tomorrow, yeah. They'll be playing... what time are they playing tomorrow? 7? 3 o'clock.
Right here.
They're playing at 7, they're coming here at 3, and they're playing, yeah, they're coming at 3 and they're playing at 7, so.
And of course, y'all travel worldwide, I assume, right?
Well, I don't know. I'm just working with them, you know. I'm friends with Joe Berger, who's a great guy in Amora, you know, who's working with John and stuff, and
When you're not involved with this Ichiku part, what do you do?
I work in Chicago, you know, and I work the clubs there, House of Blues, and I do technician and stuff there. And I do some places in England, some music festivals, kind of like this in England, you know, like Glastonbury Festival, and I don't know if you heard of them.
And from what I can think of, a lot of the views from a lot of our cable viewers here in America is that they're, you've got these baby boomers kind of reaching the middle age crazies, and they would like to go back and relive their past back in the 60s, 70s, and 80s. Is this going on in Great Britain and the rest of the world too?
Well, they've had a lot of music festivals in Great Britain for like ever since the, you know, since the 60s. I mean, they haven't died out. They just got stronger, you know. So, I mean, it's a different musical atmosphere, I think, in Britain as it is to here. Like, this happens like all over Britain, like in different counties in England all year round. Glastonbury Festival, Reading Festival, you know. You used to have the Stonehenge Festival, but now that's cancelled, you know. And you have Phoenix Festival. There's so many festivals, and it's like, and they're all like 4-day events like this. So, I mean, I'm hoping this is going to be good, because, I mean, America needs something like this, where people can come together. And, I mean, Woodstock seems to be like a, seem to be more like a big outdoor fraternity, you know, kind of crash, you know, drunken college kids, you know. Didn't seem to be my cup of tea, you know, but
going back and reliving your early part of life, it's kind of a nostalgia.
Yeah, it's nice if you have nice. I mean, I'm not that old, you know. I'm only 33, so. But yeah, I mean, I like to see the outdoor festivals where they create that same atmosphere as they did in Woodstock and they did in the olden days, you know. I mean, the olden days. I mean, you know, in the 60s. But yeah, I mean, it's. I think it's good. I mean, I think it's a positive, it's a good positive thing that's going on. I mean, I just wish that they had better bands, you know. Not like, I don't mean, not including this, I'm talking about like Woodstock was kind of more of a kind of aggressive thing, I think, and it was more, you know, young college kids getting drunk and being aggressive and, you know, throwing bottles at each other and doing crazy stuff. I mean, I'm not into that kind of stuff, you know what I mean? In Glastonbury and in the festivals in England, it's a lot more, they have a lot more younger bands, but they're more bands who are more up and coming. They're not really kind of these ragey, kind of crazy bands. It's more, they're more kind of nicer, kind of mellow rock, and, you know, it's nice. I mean, it brings the older people together, the younger people, it brings them all together, and that's what's so fun about these festivals, is having young and older people all coming together just for the music, you know. But what more can I say?
A lot of people like to relive their past in this music.
Oh yeah, I think a lot of people kind of do. Yeah, they do. And I think you can't really relive your past. You can only go forward, I think, you know. And I think that's why I'm saying the difference is in England, there's a lot more of younger bands who are creating this atmosphere, but then younger new bands with new songs, new lyrics, you know, new music. And I think that's great, you know. But I think a lot, this is more of like an oldies festival, I think, because a lot of the people who are playing here are kind of not, I'm not going to say has-beens, you know, because they're pretty established people, but you know, they're older people, you know, from bands, you know. I mean, Sunday's a great day. Sunday, I think, is the best day for me, really. I mean, you know, I mean, except for the John Entwistle Band, I think, you know, America and David Gates of Bread. I mean, it's just really nice kind of festival music, you know, sitting down on the grass and just enjoying the tunes, you know, the acoustic music. I'm more acoustic man myself, you know.
And of course, it's a shame, I guess, that the Who broke up, didn't they?
It's a shame, yeah, but sometimes a lot of people say it's a good thing, you know, because then they keep that prestige past, you know, they keep that. I mean, you know, sometimes a lot of bands, they stay together and they try to do something and it spoils what they used to be, you know. And I think by, you know, the Who breaking up, I mean, they've always kept what they've got. And I mean, it's great that the other guys, you know, Roger and Pete and all them guys are all like doing their own thing and they're doing a lot of stuff, you know. I mean, Roger's into more acting and stuff now and doing more kind of, you know, kind of film operas and stuff. And Pete Townsend's doing stuff with a lot of younger guys, playing with a lot bunch of younger guys and doing a lot of great stuff. So
really, you know, the band broke up, but the members of the band are seeing a lot more opportunities.
Oh, all of them, yeah, they've always stayed active. I mean, all of them stayed active, but, well, except for Keith, you know, I mean, he's dead, but, yeah, but I mean, they've all stayed active, which is a good thing. I mean, there's still a lot of good bands that are playing. I mean, like the Rolling Stones and people like this, they're great bands, and they're still creating good stuff. But there's also a lot of bands who have, like, kind of, I don't know, passed out over the last 10, 15, 20 years. And then, and I think there's a big craze right now. I don't know if you've noticed, but there's a lot of these bands, older bands, coming together now and doing these concerts and stuff. You know, it's kind of, I think it's a big craze right now, you know, for younger people to come out and do.
And again, you're finding this in other countries like Australia. They're having the same kind of phenomenon.
No, England, not Australia. I don't know about Australia.
Y'all haven't been to Australia and done some concerts like this yet?
No, no, not Australia, I haven't, no. But in England, they have a lot, you know, and they've started doing a few here, you know. I mean, there was another one. Where was that other one? In Ohio. There was a good one in Ohio. You know, they had a great time there, and they had like a, you know, a tribute to the Grateful Dead there, where they had the Jerry Garcia band, and it was on a lake and everything. That was a 3-day event, which was really well. It went nice. There was no trouble. I mean, it kind of went on the same time, almost a couple of days after Woodstock, you know. But I think it was a much better event. I mean, Woodstock was just a mess. I mean, Woodstock was an embarrassment. I think they shouldn't even call it Woodstock, because I mean, it wasn't in Woodstock. It was nothing to do with Woodstock. So, you know, I think it was a real embarrassment, really, I think, to Woodstock. I mean, for the people who represent Woodstock, I think they're pretty upset. I don't know. I would imagine, anyway. So.
But what do you think about the Jimi Hendrix's? Did you see some of that tonight?
That was tonight. No, yeah. I didn't see that. We've already missed that.
He put on a good show. He played the guitar with his mouth like Jimi Hendrix. It was a
Who was playing the guitar then? I mean, I know Mitch Mitchell. I saw Mitch Mitchell.
Yeah, he was here.
And who was he? It was his band. Was it any other members? Any other members like Noel Redding? I know.
There were several of them here that represented the part of the old Jimi Hendrix band. They did a real good job.
But I'd like to see Noel, because I've met Noel in Ireland. He lives out in Ireland by a friend of mine, and he goes to the local pub there, just drinks. I mean, he's kind of really quiet. He still does music and stuff, but he's lived in Ireland for a long time now, and he lives just not far from my friend in County Donegal. But I don't know if he was with him. I saw on the setup thing on the paper that it was Mitch Mitchell, and I didn't see anything about Noel Redding, so I don't know who was playing with the Jimi Hendrix band. I don't know. Do you know who the guitarist was?
I can't think of it, but anyway, it was great.
The Gypsy Sun Experience.
Gypsy Sun.
Was it the Gypsy Sun's band?
Yeah, that was here. They were here earlier.
Canada, the Canadian band?
I'm not sure where they're from. Where? Did you know? But anyway, I don't know.
A great
lineup here. A lot of nostalgia bands coming up here for the next 3 days and nights. And it is a great phenomenon.
It looks pretty good. Yeah, there's a lot of like old names and stuff playing there. You know, I mean, I see the David Gates and I see America and I see a lot of, I think the Oyster Cult. I think they already played there.
They played tonight, and Sammy Hager's finishing up. Okay. And we got a lot of great time. We got Steppenwolf with John Kay.
That's tonight.
That's later on this weekend. We have the Marshall Tucker Band, Ozark Mountain Daredevils, David Gates with Bread, and David Clayton Thomas with Blood, Sweat, and Tears. We got the Buckinghams.
Is that Lindsey Buckingham? Is it? You know,
No.
Is that the Buckinghams? Or
I don't think so.
It's a different
band. But anyway, we're gonna be here for the next 3 days and nights, and it's a great happening here in Middle Tennessee.
Yeah, it is.
It looks like this thing's taking off worldwide. You know, people are tired with the media, the depressing news that you hear worldwide, and everything that goes on, and here you got this great music, and music does, it's a psychological,
it's the greatest therapy in the world.
It is the greatest therapy in the world. It's beautiful.
You know, when it's great music, I mean, even aggressive music is, if you're into it, but I think aggressive music kind of gets a bit tired, it kind of gets a bit overdone a bit, you know, and it's, Bob Dylan wrote protest songs. I mean, you had a lot of people who did protest songs, Donovan, all these people in the 60s, but I mean, they did it in a different way. And I think to do it in a kind of mellow kind of way is, it gets through to people more, because they sit there and listen rather than jump about and bang their heads and forget what they were listening to, you know.
But it is kind of it's worldwide universal therapy for today's world.
They need to have more of this. What they need to do is they need to put this in the media spotlight and not Woodstock, because Woodstock is going to turn a lot of crazy young kids crazy, you know.
But hopefully we got a lot of other positive things. This thing could happen in Canada, Great Britain, Australia, South Africa, all over the world. This is what mankind needs more of, is great music, and what the world needs now
bring
is love.
Bring people together. You know, all color, race, you know, no matter what. You know, bring them together and bring them and all, let them enjoy the music, you know, and camp out together. I mean, we're just camping here, you know. We don't want to stay in the tray. We just want to camp out and enjoy it and meet people and have a nice time, you know. That's what it's all about.
And again, for the cable viewers out there, you are representing the John Entwistle Band, Remnants from the Who, and they're going to be playing here this weekend.
They're going to be playing tomorrow night, yeah. So come on down
Friday night here at Itchy Two Park.
Tomorrow and get on down. They're playing at what time are they playing tomorrow?
7 o'clock.
7 o'clock. Okay.
That's twice. God bless you.
I'll tell you what.
This music just brings the world closer together.
Yeah, it does. It's lovely. It's great. You know, I mean, I think it's great. Hopefully it'll be a good event, you know. I mean, I hope it all goes well. I mean, you know, it's the start, so we don't know how it's going to go, but it seems really nice. It's out in the country. It's away from all the concrete jungle of the world, you know. It's out in the country, in the fields with the natural pastures, you know. And hopefully it'll be a good, lovely weekend, so come on down.
All right, you never know what you're going to see on Tennessee Valley Cable Network. I'm Dave Parrish, and I'll tell you what, this is the highlight of my whole life out here. It's your Coupe Park 99 to talk to international people. You know, we were down at the Akoi Fest in 96 talking to the international athletes.
Festival?
The Akoi River Fest during the 1996 Olympics.
Oh, okay. In Atlanta,
They had the whitewater part down at the Akoi River. Talked to people all over the world. They have a World Cup down there. And I'll tell you what, this top set, you know, we got people coming together for a common thing, music. And it just takes the stress off
and
everything.
Lovely, yeah, I mean, it's great. People can come here and they can park their cars up. They don't have to drink and drive. You know, I mean, you know, it's great. They can just park their car and camp out, you know, and, you know, cook food and stuff and enjoy meeting other people. And just, it's just a great place to come together. You know, it's a good, music is the therapy. That's it.
Well, pardon me, folks, but I think I'm going to go over here and cry because this is the highlight of my life right here.
At
Ichiku Park 99.
We hope to see y'all next year. And you as well. Take care.
Bring Elton with you next time.
Okay, I will. Yeah, and Rod as well.
Stay with us right here on Tennessee Valley Cable Network. What can I say? Just glad to be alive and be in Tennessee. Y'all stay with us right here on Tennessee Valley Cable Network. You never know what you're going to see next. Hey, folks, we're out here at Ichiku Park having a great time. We got some folks here. Where are y'all from?
We're from Huntsville, Alabama.
Y'all, what's your name?
Adrian.
Huntsville, Alabama.
Yes, I am.
Hey, is this first time to take in something like this?
For me, well, a little bit. She just got back from Woodstock, so she's used to this.
Did you go to the last Woodstock in New York?
Yeah.
Did you get out of there early enough?
I got out of there right as the fires and stuff were starting, so
we
were pretty safe. No, I didn't. We got out of there in time, yeah.
Let me know, what's your favorite here today or this weekend? Do you have any favorites?
Definitely Joan Jett. She was awesome. She did awesome, yeah.
I didn't know she shaved her head off there. I hadn't been keeping up with these people, but I remember when she had long black hair.
Yeah, that was in the 80s.
Yeah. I thought we was here to kind of relive the past, but maybe not.
She's all shaved down and bleached out now. But she still sounds the same. Sounds good. Amazingly, Rick Springfield looked identical to he did in 1984.
Yeah. We didn't get to see him. We got in here a little too late, but we got John Kay and Steppenwolf and Styx.
I've seen them.
Name a few.
Yeah. I saw Steppenwolf at Big Spring Jam in Huntsville, Alabama last year. So, seen them before.
All right. Well, we're waiting for the next act, which is what?
I think it's Bad Company. They're switching around on us, so we don't really know.
All right. Hey, nice talking with us out here.
Thank you.
Y'all have a great time.
Bye.
All right. Just having a great time, and of course they are getting ready for another great event right up here on the stage. And as we told you, they're shooting high-definition television out here during the whole four-day events. And they're calling it a high-definition camping experience out here at Ichiku Park. Just a lot of folks here trying to stay cool in all the sun. They seem to have a fire truck out here trying to keep them wet and cooled off, courtesy of the rural fire departments here in Coffee County. Having a great time cooling these people off out here. kind of a lull in the action here at Ichiku Park. Hey, we got a guy right here that's got a tie-dye shirt on there. What's your name? Where are you from here?
Bud, Murfreesboro, Tennessee.
All the way from Murfreesboro, and you're all sitting out here in this hot sun.
That's it.
It's all worth it, though, isn't it?
I guess it is. I guess it is. I found out why they call it Ichiku Park, though, for the true meaning of it. The campgrounds are covered with sumac and poison ivy, so you get an itch going, you know what I'm saying? Never seen so much poison ivy all my life. Other than that, it's been fantastic.
Well, I hadn't had any great need to get in the bushes. You must be doing something we don't know about.
She hadn't arrived yet, so she had to go to, you know, one of these, well, you know, into town for provisions, that sort of thing. So that's where we're at with it.
You got any favorites out here this weekend?
Well, Paul Rogers is coming up, is he not?
Yeah.
Yeah, I love him. Yeah. Yeah. I like the morning show this morning. Marshall Tucker and Ozark Mountain Daredevils. Don't get to see much of them, so love them.
All right.
Yeah.
Hey, thanks for talking with us. We'll see you. Have a good time this weekend out here at Ichiku Park 99.
Well, stay cool.
Hey, we're gonna try to stay cool. we got more people we're going to talk to out here. Having a great time. Here's a couple right over here that are cooling off in the sun. You're cooling off there. Got that umbrella. Where are y'all from?
Columbia.
Right over in Columbia, Tennessee, right?
Right.
You have any favorites out here today?
Hey, let's go.
It's all a good show, right?
Yep, good show.
Hey, thanks for talking with us.
Here. Oh,
we got some other people here from down around Alabama, right?
Yeah, yeah.
Coleman?
Yeah. She's from Coleman. I'm from Ardmore, up close to Huntsville, Alabama.
All right. Hey, do you like this part of the area?
Yes. Yes, a lot. This is great. It's set up. Somebody's went to a lot of work to do this. Everything here you need.
Now, you've been over getting cooled off there with the fire department spray?
No, but we looked at it. We're not that hot yet.
Not that hot yet, huh?
Nope.
I mean, the music might get a little hotter than the weather here today.
Yeah. Yeah, we like the sun.
Do you have any, y'all have any favorites as far as performers here today?
Well,
favorites at all?
No. We haven't seen any yet.
Yeah. You like the whole thing, right?
Uh-huh.
So y'all just got here evidently?
Yeah, earlier. Two or three hours ago.
Now you're gonna be camping out here tonight?
Yep. Yeah, we've got a Winnebago over there and we're staying.
Alright, you're gonna stay till Sunday. Huh?
Probably. All right. Probably.
Well, we got a lot of great groups coming up tonight. We got the John Kay, Steppenwolf, Bad Company getting ready to come up here in a few minutes.
Uh-huh.
Sticks, the group Sticks.
Yeah.
You like them?
Yes, I like them. Yeah. Yes.
All right. Y'all have a great time.
All right.
Stay cool. Thank you.
Thank you.
And of course, folks, we're out here at Ichiku Park right here by the stage. Thank you very much. And they're playing a little of Santana music here, kind of get them ready in the mood for the next group here coming up, which is Paul Rogers of Bad Company. Just a lot of work going into this stage. The whole thing out here. Having a great time at Ichiku Park 99. We're going to be bringing you more raw video, I guess you'd say. And I kind of like these TV screens. They just do a great job. All new stuff. And of course, this is the Ichiku mascot out here, right? Ichiku mascot. And having a great time out here at Ichiku 99. Y'all stay with us right here on TVCN. We got audio, we're rolling. Raw video time here at Ichiku Park, right? We're rolling. This is Joan Jett. As a matter of fact, Joan Jett is making her exit here of the area.
Get Porky out of the way. Get Porky out of the way.
Come over here. Get a shot of Joan Jett there, if you can. Joan Jett, of course, leaving the area in a great vehicle. Can you zoom in there? All right, there. Get Joan Jett, the Joan Jett of the and the black hearts, there she goes, leaving the area. I remember when she had a great long black hair, I'll tell you what, but she has shaved her head.
No black hair now.
Of course, she does a good job there, still balls out a great song. Hey, we're having a great time out here at Ichiku Park. Look at this great bus. I'm telling you what, it's got the Ozark Mountain Daredevils written on it. A lot of people, I assume a lot of the people that have performed here have signed their name, is that right? Anyway, Ichiku artists, please sign me to support the Cancer Society. And they've done, looks like they've done a good job. And look at all those great folks. And of course, Joan Jett's still trying to get her way out, make her way out of here. We've run into a little bottleneck as they are leaving the grounds. We are here at the Ichiku Park grounds, backstage, having a great time out here. Cable Access TV. Yeah, oh, there they go. Here, right around here. Who's that? Who's that just getting on there? That's one of our drummers, I believe. I saw him up there playing the drums. Is that his name?
His name is Tommy.
Tommy.
The hair is Tommy.
Yeah. A great inspiration for the tattoo industry, I see.
Pipe hair's Doug.
Yeah. Yeah. Anyway.
Sean hasn't come out yet.
Anyway, these rock stars coming and going. It's like Grand Central Station out here behind the stage, out here at Ichiku 99. Now, what's your name? Where are you from? Swing on around over here, there, Miss Can. There it is. Hey, your name, where are you from?
Cindy Cunningham from Atlanta, Georgia.
All the way from Atlanta. Y'all three of you from the Atlanta
area?
He's
from Brazil.
I'm from Brazil.
Brazil.
Yeah.
And your name?
Michael.
Where are you from?
Atlanta.
Atlanta.
Yes.
What part of Brazil are you from?
I'm from Sao Paulo.
Oh, yeah. Nice area down there.
It's a big city.
I had an internet date with a woman down there a while back.
AOL.
I love it.
We have a good time on the internet with you folks down here.
Oh, really?
Right.
Yeah.
I'll tell you what, how long you been in the United States from Brazil?
Just a month.
Just a month?
Yeah, on vacations.
All right. Hey, bring any good stuff with you. The exports of Brazil, you know, they make some
he left
great
the
exports.
And the coffee and all. He left it all. Yeah. Chocolate.
Hey, you see this?
Is that right? Well, we're glad to have you up here at Ichiku 99 all the way from Brazil. Thank you. I remember when Joan Jett had her hair just as black as she's got right there.
Wow.
What in the world happened? I mean, what's happened to this younger generation?
I don't know.
Well,
maybe they're older now.
Maybe she decided to shed her skin.
Yeah, shed her skin.
I guess you
grow again.
To keep up with the business, you got to change your appearance.
You do.
Is that right?
It's part of
you
coming do. Out of the closet, I think.
What, is that right? Oh, is she really?
No.
Oh, okay.
I didn't say that. I said I'm maybe.
Okay. Well, anyway, we're here at Ichiku Park 99 having a great time out here.
Yes, we are.
The folks, Brad Baker, hats off to Brad. He's done a great job out here putting this thing together. All of the money and all of the work that's gone into this, making it a great time.
It's beautiful.
And it is. I just wish it was about 20 degrees cooler. Maybe we can have this 30. In October next time, right?
Yes, the fall festival.
Now, y'all stay with us right here on TVCM. We'll be back with more from Ichiku 99.
Woo!
We're rolling. We got audio. We got video. We got Forrest Gump, as
Hello.
A matter of fact, right?
It's nice to be here, sure enough, at Ichiku. I came out to tell everybody that I'm going to be throwing my shrimp boat cap into the political arena, sure enough. I've decided that I'm going to run for president of the United States of America. I think it's a good thing. I kind of decided that I wanted to run because of that Jesse, the governing body, Ventura. Are y'all familiar with Jesse, the governing body?
Yeah.
Well, I figured that if he can make it all the way to governor, I have a pretty good chance to make it to the presidency of the United States of America. And another reason that I decided to run was because of that mascot crisis. Are you familiar with the mascot crisis?
Oh, yeah, sure.
It's a big one in the United States of America today. You see, those Republicans, they got that elephant as a mascot. I don't much care for that. And the Democrats, they got that donkey as a mascot. I sure don't care for that. So I figure that for my independent campaign, I'm going to choose me the shrimp, because the shrimp kind of represents the small man, the common man,
Amen.
The disenfranchised masses that, you know, are tired of big government and, you know, BS and that kind of thing. Anyway.
Forrest Gump, it's a delight to have you out here at Ichiku 99. and we hope to see you back here in the 2000 show, right?
I would like to be back, and when I come back, I'm going to have me these t-shirts. You know, are you familiar with the yin yang symbol? Have you ever seen the yin yang symbol?
Yeah, I believe
well,
I have. Yes.
It's going to be like the yin yang, but it's going to be different. Instead of the white dot and the black dot, I'm going to have me a black elephant and a white donkey, and then the caption under the yin yang symbol is going to be, "Get those yin yangs out of DC." Showing up.
Hey,
that's what it's
going
to be. And then, but then the back of my t-shirt is going to say something positive like, "Run, Forrest, run," or "May the forest be with you," something like that. A good slogan.
Hey,
but anyway, I need a grassroots constituency, so if you're not politically, you know, affiliated, please vote for me.
Now, Mr. Gump, I'm sure you've got a site on the internet, don't you, where people can click on and see you? Do you have anything yet?
Well, you know, I am kind of low-tech, but I'm getting there because Lieutenant Dan says that you must be on the internet, so we're getting it going.
All right. Hey, that sounds great. I tell you what, you're doing a good job out here at the Ichiku 99. You got that Run Forest Run thing going over here, right?
It's his slogan, Run Forest Run.
Well, I don't know if it's my slogan. I think it's the one that people like the most, because one of the slogans would be, you know, "May the Force be with you," kind of from that Star Wars movie.
Yeah.
Another one could be "See the forest instead of the trees," or that George Bush guy. You know, the trees stand for Al Gore because he's kind of a tree-hugging, you know, wooden kind of person. But I don't want to run a smear campaign. I want to stand on my own two running shoes. So I think that my slogan will just be "Run, Force, Run."
Looks like you got some shoes down here. They're well worn.
Well, you know, you can tell a lot about a person by their shoes, you know, where they've been, where they're going, whether they've stepped in caca or not, that kind of thing.
I wanted to drive him over here. He decided to run by the car. He runs everywhere.
Now you get over here. Are you his official spokesman over here?
Well, no.
Actually, I'm his publicist.
This is MC Terry. Yeah. He's a publicist slash rapper.
Hello there, people. Mom, Forrest. This is my mom, right? Forget it.
Hello, Mama. It's good to be. Your mama probably full of proverbial folk wisdom, like my mama.
Yeah, and she's a big fan of yours as well. I hope we can go over there for dinner afterwards.
Mom. Okay, that would be good. Is she having shrimp?
I think I can make a call.
Bubba Gump shrimp. Is the finest shrimp.
Yeah, we're going to get over and have some of that shrimp. We've got a Cajun food booth up here.
Actually, we're going to donate a bunch of bubble gump shrimp. And it's been warm for a while, but at least we're, you know, it's thought counts, and we're going to give it to you guys.
Okay.
And Mr. Gump, Forrest Gump, of course, is here at the Ichiku 99 show, and you're one of the official entertainers here today.
He just killed
really?
Him at the other stage.
Sure enough. I had a packed house, and just trying to get the word out about my campaign and that kind of thing. So if you're not politically affiliated out there, and you kind of, you know, need to vote for someone with a little bit different twist on things, you could just write me in.
Now, I want to tell you, congratulate you, because you don't have any tattoos, rings in your ears, nose, eyes, and all that to entertain the folks out here today. You're a clean cut guy, and we're proud of you. You're a role model. We appreciate that.
Well, I believe
a lot of people out there appreciate that.
I believe, like my mama said, that stupid is as stupid does, and I don't drink unless I'm thirsty, and I never smoke unless I'm on fire, and I try to keep that to a minimum.
And you are certainly a role model for many of our cable viewers out there. I'll tell you what, we do represent high morals out here at Ichiku 99.
Amen.
You see it right here, right?
Well, I believe that all things work for good for those who love God and who are called according to His purpose. So I think that if you're a loving person and you believe that all things are going to work for good, then you're going to see the good in all things. And I think if you see the good in all things, you're going to find good things.
All right. Sure enough. Remember, run, Forrest, run.
Run, Forrest, run. It's a great pleasure to have you out here on our show, Tennessee Valley Cable Network, and we appreciate it. It's been a great pleasure and an honor to have you on our show.
Thank you very much.
For the thousands of cable viewers. Forrest Gump, thank you very much.
Bye.
Hey, you never know what you're going to see next right here.
Talk to Paul Rogers with Bad Company.
All right, Paul Rogers and Bad Company coming up on the stage. We're out here at Ichiku Park. It feels like Saturday, but it's just Friday. We got the rest of the day. We got Steppenwolf and John Kay tonight. We got Styx. We got all those groups all weekend long. I don't know whether I can stand it or not. Where's that igloo cooler, Andy? Hey, we got to go off the air. Y'all stay tuned. You never know what you're going to see next right here on the Tennessee Valley Cable Network. Cable viewers, of course, we're still out here at Ichiku Park 99. We got a native Coffee Countyan, Manchester. Matter of fact, what's your name?
Tammy Harrington.
Tammy, you understand you are a local girl that does travel to Great Britain, right? England?
Yes, sir. That's where I live now for 3 years. So I've just come back to visit my family.
What? Why come you to decide to uproot here and go to England?
My husband's in the Air Force. My husband's in the Air Force there, and I come back each year to visit, and I made it in the summer this time.
Is that right?
Mm-hmm.
All right. Great thing, I'm gonna give the camera to Debbie, and she's gonna take the headset. I wanna come right over here and put my head on. Anyway, the British artists are represented well here at the concert.
Yes, they are. And I was really surprised to see the MC is a British person too. Makes a touch of home for me coming back home to visit.
So are you still living in England?
Yes, sir. Another 5 more years.
And what branch of the service is your husband in?
The Air Force.
The Air Force. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Was he involved in this NATO stuff they had lately?
Oh, yeah. He does all that.
So how long are you here back to the hometown?
I'll be here through Labor Day. this was a nice surprise to come in and have this going on. It's a great thing for Manchester.
I'll tell you what, you've already got a little English accent. I don't know whether you knew it or not. Anybody tell you that?
Everybody there tells me I'm definitely from the South, and then I have people here tell me I live in England. But it's a really big time out here, and everybody should come out.
I'll tell you what, we talked to a guy representing the John Entwistle Band, of course, the Who.
Uh-huh.
We helped them put their tent together last night, and a great bunch of people here. Just it's kind of therapy for the world, musical therapy for the world, is the way he put it.
Oh yes, I would definitely say so. It's families out here. Everybody's having a big time. It's something to see.
I'll tell you what, it doesn't get any better than right here in Manchester, Tennessee. I hope they come back next year.
Oh yes, I'll definitely plan my trip for this time if they're back again.
All right. Have a great Ichiku 99.
Certainly, thank you.
Y'all stay with us right here on TVC, and you never know who you're going to see next. I'm telling you what, a lot of people having a great time out here at Ichiku Park 99. We're rolling out here to Ichiku 99, folks, and I'll tell you what, we got more of these Jesse Ventura lookalikes out here. We got a guy right here. Where are you from?
Decatur, Alabama.
All the way from Decatur, Alabama. And now I'm not going to, a lot of people would like to know, are you in the wrestling business?
No, I'm not.
What do you do for a living?
I'm an electrician at a hospital.
Electrician at a hospital. I'll tell you what, but you're doing a good job and you're enjoying the Ichiku 99 show, right?
Yes, I am. Having a great time.
Having a great time.
Yes.
Is this the first great experience like this that you ever had?
Put it like this, it's the first concert I've been to in probably about 20 years.
20 years?
Yeah.
Like me, I watched Joan Jett up there on the stage and she done shaved her head. I remember back in the early 80s, she had black hair.
Yes.
And then when she sung I Love Rock and Roll, she done shaved her head and punctured her skin and all that.
I didn't see that. I didn't. We were still at the camper.
Is that right?
Yeah.
Y'all going to be camping out all weekend here?
Yeah, we'll be here till Sunday.
All right. Hey, welcome to Coffee County in Manchester. All the way from
Decatur, Alabama.
All right. Hey, I'll tell you what, don't get any better than this, does it?
No, I don't. I'm having a great time.
Stay with us right here at Ichiku Park 99. We're going to be talking to a lot of people from all walks of life up here visiting the greater Coffee County area. Stay with us, TVCN. Hey, Debbie says we're rolling. We got raw video rolling. You know what that means. We're going to have more fun out here at Ichiku 99, right?
Yeah, oh yeah.
And for the cable viewers out there, could we get your name and where in the world are you coming from here?
Ben from Nashville.
All the way from Nashville?
Oh, yeah, all the way. And long way.
You could have said San Francisco or Berkeley and they were believing.
No, I'm not from the Gay Bay. Yeah, well, you are. Okay.
I tell you what, did this music remind you back when it was a better time or what?
It's the same time.
Yeah.
No difference. Same time.
Same time.
Yeah. Leave me alone.
You have any favorites out here tonight or this weekend?
Everything.
The whole concept is just mind-blowing.
Yeah, I don't have a mind to blow. I was in the 60s. I don't remember, so I was there.
And a great coming together of people. Therapy for all the people of the world.
Oh, yeah, the energy's great. Everybody's cooperating with everybody. It's really neat.
Hey, a wedding.
A wedding in 15 minutes at the gate. I noticed we got a couple getting married tomorrow when in the Gata DeVita plays up in the hot air balloon, right?
Uh-huh. It's not me.
are you already smoking four, or are you just batching it out here today?
I'm a bachelor engaged.
Is that right?
Yeah.
Did you got your
She's taking a shower.
Is that right? Yeah. All right. I'll tell you what, you have eclipsed the whole show here, representative of the Thai people for this thing. They got more groups coming up here on the stage. Mike, you were talking with us at Ichiku 99.
Ichiku 99, yeah!
All right. You don't get any better than this right here in Manchester, Tennessee. We hope they'll be back another year. Stay with us right here on TVCN. Ichiku 99. We got some people here from Bloomington, Indiana. Is that right?
Right.
And what's your name?
Lance Wright.
You got your wife here with you?
Yeah, my wife, Patricia.
Now, how did you find out about the Ichiku 99?
We've been planning this for 4 or 5 months now. We've seen it on the internet.
The internet. This says a lot for the internet marketing because, that's how they were marketing most of the stuff here.
Yeah.
Now, do you follow a lot of the concert circus throughout America?
No, we go to kind of oldies stuff usually.
The music, the lineup of artists kind of appeal to you?
Yeah, we go like 60s type stuff mostly.
Kind of grew up with them and once you
Takes you back in time, doesn't it?
Yeah. I got a friend that's a counselor at Bedford North Lawrence School, and me and him go to Oldies concerts all the time. We've seen this, the Rock All-Star, the All-Star is going to be here a couple of times now.
We haven't given you any air time. What do you like about the Ichiku 99 right here in the camera?
It's fabulous. I'm usually an old fogey, but I love this. This is wonderful. My husband's a music freak, so I follow him around there where he goes, but I think I'm enjoying this one as much as he is. We're here with some friends, Norm and Annette Taylor, but they went to get something to eat, I think.
I'll tell you what, it's a great coming together of people. We talk to people from all over the world, Great Britain and otherwise. It's musical therapy for the world, right?
It is, right. It's wonderful. Right. It's good for the soul.
Do you have any favorites out here this weekend, like John Kea, Steppenwolf, and Styx? What about Tommy James and the Shondells tomorrow night?
Oh, we've seen them before at Bloomington at Bryan Park, Tommy James and the Shondells.
Good job on that Disco Blue Persuasion, Randy.
They're excellent, excellent group. Every group here has just been really, really good. They've really done a good job.
Yeah, Brad Bakers, we salute you. You brought a bunch of people together here for a great cause. And that's to have a great time right here in Manchester, Coffee County, Tennessee. Y'all stay with us at Itchy. Wait a minute. We on now? We got battery? I can swap batteries.
Hi, Dave.
I'm a great swapper. I like swapping. Oh, anyway.
Uh-oh.
Anyway, how's things been going out here?
Dave, this is going to be seen in your hometown. You can't say things like that.
I'll tell you what, we do enjoy cable access. We're cable access.
I know you are. Tennessee Valley Cable Network. Yeah. I knew that. See, pretty good memory for an old hippie.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's good. You having fun?
And we enjoyed talking to all the folks out here. We especially enjoyed our interview with Forrest.
Forrest Gump, you see, yeah. You know, stupid is as stupid does. He told me that. He said, you know, you're pretty stupid. And I said, well, stupid is as stupid does. He says, damn, I should have said that first. And he did. So there you go. Cool, everybody. Hi, remember me? We had a little interview yesterday, and here we are again. And
are you going to be able to persevere throughout the whole weekend?
Sure, no problem. I'm having a great time, and I'm holding up pretty good for an old clown. So this is one of my fans here.
Look here. Get him up here.
My fan.
Look over here.
I don't know what this kid's name is, but he's a nice kid.
Except
he keeps stealing my nose, and I'm going to have to beat him to death in a little while. But that's okay. No, I'm just kidding. I'm just kidding. I wouldn't do that because he's a nice kid, right? What's your name?
Check this box out.
What is it? Buddy. This kid's name is Buddy. So, Buddy, we're going to be on TV. Maybe you can see yourself on TV. So this is Buddy. You having a good time?
Yeah.
Yeah? This is Dave. He's the boss man. And you'll maybe be on TV soon if you live close. Okay? Can I have my nose back? Please? Please? Be nice and give me my nose back, Buddy. Who's Buddy Art Buddy? Buddy, Buddy, Buddy. Ooh, careful with those feet, Buddy.
Having a good time out here at Ichiku 99.
We're having a wonderful time.
We see you again on Saturday and Sunday.
I hope to see you again next year and the year after that and the year after that is what I'm counting on. So we'll see. See you later, okay? Tennessee Valley Cable Network. I got to go back to work before the next band starts. So I can't be a media circus. It's a media circus.
Hey, stay with us. I tell you what.
Monica.
Stay with us right on TVC, and y'all stay with us. Ichiku 99. We got more talent on the stage, more arts and crafts and vendors. It's a mind-blowing experience here. Hats off to Brad Baker and all the folks out here at Ichiku 99. Stay with us right here on TVCN. We're rolling. Hey, this guy don't have no trouble making friends out here tonight. He's got the best seat in the house. The best seat in the house, literally, right here at Ichiku Park, right here. Right?
They're hard to blow up, though, I'll give you that. And it would never be blown up again if I didn't get a pump this morning.
All right.
Cool.
You're going to have the best seat in the hat.
I'm ready to kick back.
All right.
Ichiku.
Hey, it don't get no better than this. Best seat in the house. You always heard it. He's got the best seat in the house right here.
That's right.
At Ichiku.
I'm gonna put it down too.
All right, go ahead. Stay with us.
Now, Forrest Gump told us to come down here and check out these shrimp. Of course, they're one of his one of his biggest supporters, I guess. And look at the size of these Louisiana shrimp. I mean, look at that. Look at that. I'm telling you what, cable viewers. Look at the size of that. You got a bigger shrimp. We're gonna taste that and a few ribs out here at the Ichiku 99 show. Hey, is that a shrimp?
That's a shrimp.
Oh no, I've never seen one that big before in my life. You know, red lobster? Hell, read my lips. You need to start stocking this kind of shrimp, you know. I'm telling you what. This come out of the Gulf of Mexico? That's not a mutant or nothing, is it? This is the real thing right here from the Gulf of Mexico. I'm telling you what, you environmentalists, leave these shrimp alone there. Look how big they are now. I'm telling you what, doesn't get any bigger than this out here at Ichiku 99. These people, I thought there was a lobster. You sure it's a shrimp?
Yeah, it's a shrimp.
You know, I have lobster this big when I go out and eat, you know. But this is a shrimp. I'll tell you what, do y'all run a restaurant anywhere?
No, we
did. Well, y'all ought to need to run a restaurant. I'm telling you what, that's a great looking shrimp.
We got a
right there.
Shrimp in Decatur, Alabama.
Decatur, yeah.
That'll feed anybody, anytime, anywhere you want to go.
Hey, that's
our
great.
www.pigshavewings.com.
Of course, Decatur, also the home of Big Bob's barbecue sauce there at the Hound Hog. You know, he won. These people have got him beat on the shrimp. I'll tell you what, they have got the greatest shrimp out here from Decatur, Alabama. We'd like to go down there and eat. Y'all need to open up a restaurant down there.
Well, we should.
In Decatur, Alabama. We're out here at Ichiku 99 having a great time. We're going to have a taste of the shrimp, taste of the ribs. And I'm telling you what, these people know how to have a good time at Ichiku 99. It's coming up on Friday evening, coming up on 6 o'clock here. We got beautiful skies. And everything's looking good here for the whole weekend at Ichiku 99. Come on down and join us. I'll tell you what, I'm going to take a little taste of this shrimp right here. Let me peel him. Can I peel him on the TV? Let me show you how easy it is. You just do this and that, and you split it apart like that. Let me show you how quick we do it, because I'm awful hungry here tonight. I'll tell you what, the head just pulls right out, and just pull that away. Got a little cocktail sauce right here. There you go, Ichiku 99. Y'all eat your heart out.
Big Sad Wings.
There it is, right there. Ichiku 99 from the folks all the way from the Gulf of Mexico. You need to come back in the year 2000. I believe they'll be doing it again, won't they?
They're supposed to.
Yeah.
Supposed to be doing it again. And I'll tell you what, the eyes have it. The eyes have it out here. Ichiku 99. Y'all stay with us.
There's a plate of shrimp.
Ichiku Park merchandise.
All right, cable viewers, we're back. We're out here Friday night at Ichiku Park 99. Getting ready to bring up John Kay and Steppenwolf here in a few minutes. And we got a great crowd. I bet we got double the crowd we had on Thursday night. Debbie, if you'll just kind of swing around to all the people here. Yeah, we got people as far as you can see out here at the Ichiku Park 99. Friday night, John Kay with Steppenwolf coming up on stage, and also Styx here tonight. And we're just trying to bring a little bit of you back home.
Meet the guys back there.
And, they got a British host. And just a great bunch of people here having a good time so far here. Just a great mellow crowd for Ichiku Park 99 out here in Manchester, Tennessee.
And the grand prize, where do they go? What do? They go to your tent, and what do?
These people just having a great time out here. And I'll tell you what, we've been enjoying the Cajun cooking out here. The ribs and the crawfish. I had to drink two or three bottles of bottled water here, and I'm just about ready to get back in the groove of things. So y'all stay with us right here at Ichiku Park 99. We're going to see some unique and interesting people here later tonight out here at the big Under the Stars in Manchester, Tennessee at Ichiku 99. Stay with us right here on TVCN. We'll be back with more festivities. Having a great time out here at Ichiku Park 99. We got some prominent citizens from over in Lincoln County, right? Petersburg.
Right, around the Petersburg area.
Right. Tally Station.
We love this place. We just had to drive about an hour to get here to have a little fun. And I think this is a wonderful thing. What's your name, Jim?
Hey, this is we're David with TVCN. I tell you what, it doesn't get any better than this, does it?
Absolutely.
Right, we're glad to have you down here. What's your favorite artist out here tonight?
Marshall Tucker Band.
You like John Kay and Steppenwolf?
Hell, I haven't seen him about a dozen times. But I was out here with Marshall Tucker, and you know, he left about dinner, and I went and got me something to eat, and I'm coming back to see John Kay.
All right.
Hey, baby.
Having a great time out here tonight.
Yeah.
Ichiku Park 99. Y'all stay with us. It don't get no better than this. Ichiku 99.
Wait a minute. Let me say one more thing. Anybody don't like this, wouldn't fight for the country.
Guy that's having the best time out here at Ichiku Park 99. And what's his name?
Trooper.
How you doing there, Trooper?
You're very good.
Are you doing very good? Are you doing real good there, Trooper? Are you having a great time? Yeah. Oh, yeah. He's having a good time. Ichiku. Having a great time out here. Oh, yeah. I'll tell you what, it don't take much to turn his tractor tonight, does it? Ichiku.
This is a mark of a very good band.
What's y'all's name? Where are you from?
We're from Murfreesboro, Tennessee.
Cindy and Larry Atkin, this is Trooper.
Y'all like this Ichiku stuff here?
Woo, we love it. It's having a great time.
All right. Hey, welcome to Manchester and Ichiku 99.
Thank you.
Thank you. I believe this dog, let's see if we can get him again there. He's gonna do it. I believe he's gonna do it. He likes it. I'm telling you what, this dog, he just gets off. It turns his tractor, folks. Right out here. I'll tell you what, he has a great time. I'll tell you what.
He's an itchy dog.
Oh, boy. I wish other women were that easy.